Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and we are going to continue with the Vishnu Sahasranam playlist. And we have very wonderfully completed the Vishnu Sahasranam. No, we completed the first invocation. All right, so it's a long way to go. And the other day in the part two, so if you have not watched part one and part two, then please go and watch. Otherwise, you may be clueless of what's going on here. So in part two, we discussed about the first invocation. Shuklam Varadharam Vishnum Shashi Varnam Chaturbhujam Prasanna Varanam Dhyayet Sarva Vigno Prashantayet. Dressed in white, O all-pervading one. So it's described here that he's dressed in white and he's compared to Shashi Varna, means the moon. Glowing with the color of the moon. Chaturbhujam, four hands. We discussed what does he have in his four hands. Okay, Shankha Chakra Gada Padma. We discussed it. Prasanna Varanam Dhyayet. I meditate on your ever-smiling face. And Sarva Vigno Prashantayet. One who removes all obstacles. So we discussed the four beautiful things which he has. The Shankha Chakra Gada Padma. So it's very important that you understand the significance of these four things. Not that you just blindly read, okay? So anybody can read the Vishnu Sahasranam in 30 minutes. It's not that difficult. But are you sure you know the meanings and the context and the mood? Okay, so three things are important. The meaning, the context, and the mood. So these three are very important. Okay. So now we will go to the next shloka. And in this, we will. I will also add another shloka, which is there from another place, because these two shlokas, the second and the third, is referring to Maharishi Vyas Dev. Okay, so let's read out the shlokas first. Then I will give some explanation on Maharishi Vyas about his origin and about his greatness, of course. And he, for your kind information, from those who are from the West who are not aware of this, that all the Vedic scriptures, most of them have been written by Maharishi Vyas. So therefore, whatever we have today in our database, in our laptops, in our books, or what in whichever format, we should eternally be grateful to Maharishi Vyas, because he was the one who compiled it. So the word Vyas means anybody who compiles, and Vyas Dev is referring to that personality who had actually compiled all of the Vedic literatures. Therefore, he is a very, very, very crucial personality, and he also appears in the Mahabharata in many places. We will discuss who he is and about his origin, and also some instances from the Mahabharata. Okay. So now the thing is, this is Vishnu Sahasranam, but why is Vyasdev mentioned here? Well, because he is a great personality and he is the Shaktyavesh avatar of Lord Vishnu. So there are six types of avatars. Let me try to recall. There is Guna avatar, there is Leela avatar, there is Purusha avatar. Then there is Shaktavesh avatar, then there is Manvantara avatar, and there is Yuga avatar. So there are these six types of avatars. So among them, Vyasdev, Maharishi Vyas, is a Shaktyavesh avatar. Shaktyavesh avatar means he's a normal human being like you and me. Not that normal also. But he is specially empowered by Lord Vishnu to do extraordinary activities. Okay, so he is not a normal human being. He is an extraordinary personality, Vyasdev. So he's a Shaktyavesh avatar. He was specially empowered by Lord Vishnu to write all the literatures, to compile all the literatures in written form. Okay, why did he do this? Because he knew that Srimad Bhagavatam says, Manda Sumanda Matayo, Manda Bhagya Upadrita, that people in Kali Yuga, their memory is very short-lived. They are always under distress. They are depressed always. They are sad. They are unhappy. They are miserable. They are lonely. They are crying. Yet they are smiling. All right. So therefore, Vyasdev, understanding the plight of the people of Kali Yuga, like you and me and all of us, he wrote all the Vedic scriptures. He compiled. थे एंड ही प्रिजर्व्ड इट एंड ही पास्ड ऑन दीज स्क्रिप्चर्स थ्रू परंपरा. सो ही इज अ शक्त्यावेश अवतार. रिमेंबर दिस. ओके, दैट्स हिज टेक्निकल आइडेंटिटी. ही इज वेरी वेरी ग्रेट इन ऑल रिस्पेक्ट्स. ओके, सो द सेकेंड श्लोक गोज व्यासं वसिष्ठनप्तारं शक्ते पौत्रवकल्मषं पराशरात्मजं वंदे शुकतातं तपोनिधिं. I bow down to you, Vyasdev, the treasure house of penance. You are the grandson of Maharishi Vasishth. You are the grandson of Shakti. And you are the son of Parashar Muni. And the father of Sukhdev Goswami. These are very, very, very great personalities mentioned here. Okay. So among all of these, I would not talk about Vasishtha and Shakti now because that will take a long time. But I would like to mention about Parashar Muni and Sukhdev Goswami. Okay. So Parashar Muni is the father of Maharishi Vyas. Okay. And his mother is Satyavati. Okay. So therefore, his son is also Sukhdev Goswami. The Sukhdev Goswami is a very great personality because Sukhdev Goswami actually, let's discuss about Vyasdev first, then we'll go to Sukhdev Goswami. So Vyasdev, his father, as you know, is Parashar Muni. And Parashar Muni, as you know, he wrote the BPHS, Brihat Parashar Hora Shastra. Okay. So he's a very important personality. And Parashara is a very great sage. He is very great. In fact, there was a great assembly one day. So in that great assembly, there was all the great sages of the entire universe. They were sitting. And then Parashar Muni was a very small boy at that time. He had entered the Sabha. And then Markandeya Rishi, who is another great sage, when Markandeya saw that Parashar Muni has entered, then he fell flat and he gave full prostrated obeisances, dandavat, ashtang pranam he did, because he was such a great personality. I mean, both of them, Markandeya and Parashar Muni. And then Parashara was embarrassed that why is this great personality falling down like this in front of everybody? I mean, who am I to get such a high level of respect? So then Markandeya Rishi, he said, and Markandeya is another great sage. He had seen Pralaya once. He requested Lord Vishnu that please show me Pralaya. Then Lord Vishnu had actually showed him the dissolution of the entire universe. You know, Pralaya, just imagine his level. So Markandeya Rishi told him that you are a very small boy now, but that doesn't mean you are actually small. You are bigger than anybody here. So you are a great personality. And although you are very small, but I know the level of knowledge and spiritual realization that you have. And catering to that, I am offering my obeisances to you. Although I am very, very, very senior to you in age. But you are senior to me in knowledge. That's what Vedic culture is. That even though you are elder, but if you see somebody who is more knowledgeable than you, you consider him or her as your senior. So therefore, this principle of respect is very much encouraged and appreciated within the Vedic context. So Parashar Muni was given full obeisances, Ashtang Pranam, by Markandeya Rishi. So you can see the exchange between these two great souls. And then Parashar Muni is also not thinking, of course, you know, it's me after all. You must pay obeisances. All right, so we have the example of Daksh Prajapati, who felt very offended when Lord Shiva did not stand up. But here, Parashara is getting embarrassed because a great sage like Markandeya is paying obeisances to him. All right, so that is another symptom of a great soul, that a great soul does not like to be in limelight. Today, in Kali Yuga, the Kali Yuga people are hungry for limelight. They are hungry for power, post, position, recognition, YouTube subscribers, or you know, like Instagram followers, Facebook friends, you know, or fake book friends. Yes, you have 50,000 subscribers, 50,000 followers, but still you are lonely. So in Kali Yuga, people want recognition and they are so hungry. They are empty inside. So to fill that void inside, which is coming because of their lack of spiritual connection to God, they try to fill in that void by using, by getting some petty name fame, which anyways withers out in no time. But we see in case of Parashar Muni, he was not wanting this name and fame. In fact, he was feeling very much embarrassed when this happened. Okay, so therefore, it's very crucial that you we take these lessons and we do not become hungry for name and fame. Of course, whatever is coming of its own accord, we accept it. So if we get some recognition, some name, fame, some limelight, that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. But the thing is, that should not become the goal of our life. Okay. So Parashar Muni, so now we will come to Vyasdev. So Parashar Muni, he's a great sage, of course, and he has written Brihat Parashar Hora Shastra, as I said. Without him, there would be no astrology. So whoever is learning astrology, you must offer your respects to Parashar Muni. And Parashar Muni, and there was another lady, mother of Vyasdev, her name was Satyavati. Okay. So Satyavati was a daughter of a fisherman. And because she used to deal with fishes all the time, so her body had a fishy smell. And one day what happened, Parashar Muni had approached this lady, Satyavati, and he had told her that, my dear Satyavati, the universal energies, the energies of the planets and overall harmony of the universe is very much supporting the incoming of a great soul now in this universe. He will be your and my son, and he will be known as Vyas, and he will be the cause of he will do great work. He will achieve great things. He will have great miracles. So therefore, if you agree, then we will unite with each other during this time, okay? And then we will have this offspring. Now, of course, Parashar Muni and Satyavati was not married at that time, and still they united. So Parashar Muni out of his, and then Satyavati agreed. Satyavati said that, I understand you are a very great sage, and if that is the will of the gods, that is your desire, and that is Lord Vishnu's desire that we unite now and we procreate, then I agree to that. But my only concern is I am a virgin, and if I lose my virginity, then nobody would marry me later on, and so in that case, who would marry me? So I would be unmarried the rest of my life. And then Parashar Muni said, I give you a blessing that if you cooperate in this great, if you sacrifice yourself in this yajna, then I promise you that you will not lose your virginity. By my blessings, by power of my penance, your virginity will be intact. And I also bless you that your body has this fishy smell. This will go out and your body will be very fragrant, extremely fragrant. Okay. So these are the two blessings which he gave her. And then when Satyavati heard this, she was convinced of Parashar Muni's power. And then she agreed to unite with him. And then Parashar Muni had, out of his tapasya, his power, he had created a island somewhere in between, okay, of the river. And then they went there, and it was almost like a heavenly planet where they united. Okay, so now of course, many times people may say, "Oh, what is this? If they are doing like this, then we can also do. Why can't we unite with somebody before marriage? Okay, we can just enjoy." So this is not like the enjoyment of the dogs, that you are just sleeping around with anybody like people in Kali Yuga these days. Okay. So that is sinful. You will get severe karmic consequences if you do all these things. Because the union of a man and a woman should ideally produce an offspring. Okay. So if you are not doing that, if you are just hovering like dogs, they do, then you will be punished. And 99% of the people don't like to hear this, but that's the truth. But in case of Parashar Muni and Satyavati, it was not like that. So they are very great personalities, Parashar Muni. So they can at times do certain things for the benefit of the rest of the universe. But we are not in a position to imitate such acts. Okay, and Parashar Muni and Satyavati were, they were not in a mood of enjoying, like, you know, like animals, like, you know, sexual or passionate or romance or something like that. There was nothing like this. Sex, the act of sex was only done for procreation. Okay, and that too only when it was done once, when the universal energies were harmonious. And that was ordained by God Himself and everybody, all the sages, all the devatas, that is what their desire was. So He had accepted that service for the benefit and upliftment of humanity. But we should not think that, okay, He did, so I can also do. Okay, so you cannot do it, I can't do it, He can. Because He's Parashar Muni. Yes, I know many people don't like to hear this. They like only fancy stuff. But yeah, that's the fact. And then what happened? Vyasdev was born inside in that island only. And therefore, another name which Vyasdev has is Dvaipayana. Okay. So therefore, his name is, now the word Dvaipayana has many meanings. I will not go into that. It can mean one who is born in an island or between two islands. So it has many meanings. But the crux is that when Vyasdev was born, he grew up there only. Okay, he was not like a baby, and Satyavati was not taking him and feeding breast milk. Okay, and Parashar Muni was also not just taking him like this in his lap. So when Vyasdev, when they united, Vyasdev was born immediately, and he grew up immediately there, and then immediately he left from there. Okay. So that is, that's how Maharishi Vyas was born. And therefore Satyavati is his mother, Parashar Muni is his father. Okay. So, and Vyasdev, he had protected the Pandavas also many times. So there was one time when the Pandavas were in Ajnatvas. Okay. And they were sent to exile. So 12 years of Vanvas and then 1 year of Ajnatvas, incognito 1 year, 12 years exile in the forest and 1 year incognito. If you are caught by somebody, then again you are going to go into 12 years of Ajnatvas and then 12 years Vanvas and 1 year Ajnatvas, like this. Okay, and the cycle would keep repeating like this. So therefore, once what happened, this Duryodhana and company, Duryodhan, Shakuni, Karna and his brother Dushasan, okay, along with all the other Kurus, 100 Kurus, they decided that the Pandavas are very weak now, so let's go and just murder them, let's just go and kill them, okay, because they are in the forest, they are weak. I mean, they were not weak, but they thought the Kurus always underestimated the Pandavas and always overestimated the themselves, basically. Okay, and this can be found in Bhagavad Gita first chapter also, where Duryodhana says that Bhavan Bhishmascha Dronascha Karnascha, he says that, oh, what is this army of the Pandavas, our army is twice. Okay, but actually that's not the fact, because the army of the Kurus was around 11 Akshohinis. And the army of the Pandavas were 7 Akshohinis. So 7 multiplied by 2 is 14. So 11 is not 14. So it's around 1.5 times of 7. But this Duryodhana, this egoistic idiot, was so much obsessed with his strength that this idiot always used to overestimate himself and underestimate the Pandavas. So he said, oh yeah, anyways, 11 and 14 are same only. So our army is double the strength, almost double, he said, no. So yeah, that's the attitude which you can see. Even in Bhagavad Gita, you can see that if you read. So then what happened? He made a plan, and then his best friend Karna supported him in this, as usual, always. And of course, what to speak of Shakuni, his uncle, and Dushasan, his brother, then Vikarna and all others. So they decided, all right, so now in when the Pandavas are alone, we will go with our entire army, we will go and wipe them out. Okay, And then they took all their armies and they were about to come out of Hastinapur, and the gates of Hastinapur opened. And at that time, Vyasadeva appeared there. Okay. And Vyasadeva was furious. He was very angry at the Kurus. He said, "You rascals, you idiots, you thugs, you liars, you cheaters. I instruct you that go back to Hastinapur now itself. If you don't go, I will curse you and your entire city will burn into ashes at this very moment." And when Duryodhana heard this, he was like, "Vyasadeva." And then Duryodhana was like, "Oh, please forgive us, you know, I will not do it. We won't attack the Pandavas now. It's my mistake. I will not repeat it. I'm sorry. Please don't curse me. You are a great sage, blah, blah, blah. All the fancy stuff. We are going. We are almost on the way. Please retreat." So Vyasadeva had protected the Pandavas, okay, because Pandavas, they are the significators of Dharma, headed by Dharmaraj Yudhishthir. And Arjuna, of course, and Bhima, Nakul, Sahadev. So Vyasadeva could not tolerate that these crooks, Duryodhana and company, including his crooked friend and crooked brother, crooked uncle, all the crooks together, they will go and murder the Pandavas like this. So Vyasadeva could not tolerate this. And he said, "You go back or you are finished. I will wipe out your entire city." Okay. And then Duryodhana, he understood that, "I dare not repeat this the next time." Okay. And he did not have the courage to repeat this again. Okay. So this is a very famous instance in the Mahabharata. Not much known, but those who have read the Mahabharata, they know about this. Okay. This was when the Pandavas were already in the forest. Okay. So this is how he protected. And later on also, when Ashwatthama had thrown the Brahmashir Astra to Uttara's womb, where Parikshit Maharaj was there in Uttara's womb. Uttara is wife of Abhimanyu, and Abhimanyu and Uttara are like son and daughter-in-law of Arjun. And Parikshit Maharaj was the emperor after Yudhishthira Maharaj left, who was in Uttara's womb. So then Ashwatthama had deflected the Brahmashirastra. And then that time also Vyasadeva tried to protect, but this Ashwatthama didn't listen when he had discharged this weapon to kill Arjuna, and then Arjuna had also discharged the Brahmashirastra, and Vyasadeva had stopped the collision of these two great weapons, because if these two would collide, there would be humongous destruction. Okay, it's like beyond comparison, unparalleled destruction. So Vyasadeva also protected the universe. And later on, he also compiled all the Vedic scriptures. And then the last thing is about his son, Sukhdev Goswami. Okay. Sukhdev Goswami is the one who spoke the entire Srimad Bhagavatam. Okay. Sukhdev Goswami heard it from his father Vyasadev, and then he narrated the entire Srimad Bhagavatam. And then the same Vyasadev who had told Sukhdev Goswami had now again written that Bhagavatam down, okay, under guidance of Narad Muni. So therefore, if there would be no Vyasadeva, there would be no Mahabharata, there would be no Srimad Bhagavatam, okay. The world would not know about Krishna also. The world would not know about Kurukshetra. The world would not know about Bhagavad Gita. So if you are hearing this, the world would not know Vishnu Sahasranam, because this is inside the Mahabharata, okay. So, if you are listening to this video, then it is highly essential that you offer your gratitude to Maharishi Vyas. Okay, and therefore, that is the shloka. Then, what is the next shloka? Vyasaya Vishnu Rupaya Vyasa Rupaya Vishnave Namo Vai Brahma Nidhaye Vasishthaya Namo Namah. I bow down to you, O Vyasa, who is Vishnu himself, and Vishnu who is Vyas. And again I bow down to you, he who is born in the family of Vasishtha. Okay. So he is born in the family of Vasishtha Muni. Vasishtha is his grandfather. Okay. So we'll speak about Vasishtha Muni some other time. Today we spoke on a bit about Sukhdev Goswami, then about Vyasadev, then about Parashar Muni, and a bit about Markandeya Rishi. Okay. These great personalities. एंड देन व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट श्लोक, अविकालाय शुद्धाय नित्याय परमात्मने सदैक रूपा रूपाय विष्णवे सर्वजिष्णवे। ओके, सो वी विल डिस्कस दिस श्लोक लेटर। ओके, एंड टुडे आई वांटेड टू डिस्कस ऑन महर्षि व्यास एंड हाउ ही वाज ओरिजिनेट, हाउ ही केम इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस एंड हु ही इज एक्चुअली एंड द थिंग्स व्हिच ही डिड एंड मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंटली हिज कंपाइलेशन। ऑलराइट, सो therefore Vyasdev is very crucial, so I would like to offer my obeisances to Maharishi Vyas and thank him for writing down all the scriptures for people like you and me and everybody else. Okay, without him we wouldn't be discussing this here today. Okay, maybe YouTube would be there, but or maybe I would be there, maybe you would be there, but maybe we would not be discussing this. All right, so let us thank him from bottom of our hearts and pray to him that he blesses us so that we can follow in the footsteps of the Mahajans. Okay, and he himself is also a great personality. All right, so therefore in the next verses we will discuss more about the next shlokas. Okay, avikaraya shuddhaya nityaya paramatman sadaika rupa rupaya vishnave sarva jishnave. Okay, let's discuss this the next time. All right, thank you very much for your time and for your patience, and if you are new to the channel then please subscribe to it, and if you want a consultation from me regarding your horoscope you can go down to the description section below of my videos, and yes, God is there with you all the time, just look to him and you will find him. Thank you very much.